issue on their part. We need to get better in a lot of areas, probably starting with our transition defense and all the way through, and execute better offensively to take some pressure off our defense. But it was one of those nights. They had a hell of a night. Give credit. We're going back to Atlanta.
What kind of was the issue with the three-pointers they were hitting? Did you at any point think about adjusting, or did you adjust how you were defending them from that one?
Well, I think, you know, one of the things that, you know, we'll go back and look at the film, but I think in transition we're not doing a good enough job of, I think probably we need greater urgency, we need a greater understanding of getting to all of their shooters. So I think it starts there. And then in the half court, I think, you know, they're in the paint probably a lot. So, you know, when you collapse or you get to the paint, people help. They're moving the ball. They're making the extra pass. They're making shots. And then the third piece is, you know, several of them, obviously J.R. Smith, are hitting extremely difficult threes on top of those first two things.
What do you tell your team after a game like this to say, hey, we're still in this?
Yeah, you know, we're going home. We're going to Atlanta. It's one game. You know, they won their two games on their home court. Now we're going home. Now the challenge is on us to have a heck of a night in Atlanta and win game three.
When Kenny wrote at WHBC in the back, after a game like this, and they were up 18 in the first game, you came back, but they won by 11. Do you think about any lineup changes? Anything to try and spark the team to get you guys back in this?
Yeah, I think we'll look at everything. You know, this is, I think going home is going to be big, but, you know, I think we can't just rely on going home. We will, we'll look at the film to a point and figure out where we can get better and, see what we come up with between now and game three.
You talked about going home and how that will be a benefit, obviously. I know guys play with a lot of pride. Does a game like this bring pride to the forefront? Does it make guys, is it a gut check? Is it a, guys, you got to have a little bit more pride, I guess?
Well, I mean, I think our group is a prideful group. And when you get beat, you know, soundly like we were tonight, I think it does, I think it does draw on that pride. And I think going back to Atlanta, I'm sure we'll come out with the right focus, with the right effort, with the right, pride, if that's the word you want to do, if that's the appropriate word.
Chris Parker, Cleveland Scene. Coach, I guess in the first game, you guys did pretty well on the boards. It seemed like in the first half, they were hurting you on the boards. Did you think that that was a big key, too, in what was going on?
Yeah, you know, it, in the first half, it was something we talked about, you know, and I do think that was probably the fourth layer to their threes. You know, when they got a few offensive rebounds and kickouts, and we've got to take care of the boards, take care of everything. There's a lot to take care of after a game like this.
Mike down here, Ray Jeske, ESPN 90. After such a monster game by Dennis on Monday night, only about 13 minutes tonight, what was the thinking there that you didn't unleash him and hope he could get you going again?
We've had a point guard rotation for the entire season. Jeff Teague and Dennis Schroeder have both been great for us all year. There are some nights when Dennis has big nights and we'll ride him a little more. Tonight I thought Jeff was playing well, and we basically stuck with our same point guard rotation. And, you know, the second half of the game was, the lead was such that playing Dennis a lot more minutes was not appropriate. And, each night it's a new game, new opportunities for Jeff and Dennis, and we'll continue to read that.
How were they different this year from when you played them last year in the playoffs? Similar results, they swept you last year, they're up 2-0, but how are they different this year?
Well, obviously right now they're shooting it just unbelievably well, whether it be the first round and now these first two games. You know, a healthy Kevin Love gives you another guy that spreads the floor, is able to make threes, create space. I think the way they're playing in transition and the way they're moving the ball. But they were excellent last year. You know, they're obviously a team that's put together well, and we're going to have to be very good to change it.
Look, you started with Paul guarding LeBron. I'm wondering what you thought of that, and did that kind of have ripple effects, making a change like that as far as how the rest of the defense and transition defense held up?
Well, you know, I mean, halfway through the first quarter, it seemed like we were in a good, you know, decent spot, and almost, you know, we took him out, I think, with, you know, 4 minutes to go, and it felt like that was when one of the runs happened. And so I thought Paul was, you know, the matchup with him on LeBron was, at least in the first quarter, felt like it was not a problem. You know, in transition, you got to look at it. There's so many things that happen in transition and see if that was something that hurt us. But, you know, for the first 8, you know, minutes for Paul's first run, you know, it was kind of a 16-18, you know, tie game or 2-3-point game.
Like they had the 25 threes and 16 twos. Halftime it was 18-6. Where is this game headed in terms of three-point usage, and what's that requiring defensively as you guys, or all teams, have to deal with this evolution on the fly?
Yeah, I mean, you know, they're obviously getting a ton of them up, and they're shooting it at a high rate. You know, the thing that, you know, they have a penetrating pitch game that, you know, they kind of pair with the three-point shooting, so I don't think you can just be one. You can't just shoot threes and not do the other things that, you know, require, you know, ball movement and attacking and all those things and playing in transition. So, you know, everybody would like to put together a great three-point shooting team, but you got to have the other pieces with it also. Thank you.